Welcome to Kansas.
How are you?
Yes.
It's good to be here.
Yesterday, no one said.
What's like the greatest thing about Kansas?
We
got nothing. But what are you known for besides like Dorothy?
We have a bunch of wheat. We're really flat.
That's sick, dude.
That's incredibly based.
I mean, it's nice out today. That's pretty
good. A little PBR rep.
It is nice.
Yeah. It filmed me while I was walking, and that was the first time anyone has done that.
Really?
Yeah.
I was excited.
I was just walking.
Yeah.
And you fist bumped, and you were recording me, and I said, "Why are you recording me?"
Well, I saw you at the end of the
street. Hot Mulligan. I went, yeah.
I saw you at the end of the street, and I was like, I don't want to be creepy and go down there and be like, "You're Tate." So I waited, and then you came, and I was like, "Yes."
The slow Tate. Approach. I see.
Yeah. Tate.
Why are you recording me?
Because you're Tate.
Walking.
And you're in Kansas.
Yeah.
I'm excited. Not the best first meeting, but we'll work on that.
Are you all here for VIP?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Heads up, we are gonna. Well, welcome everybody to VIP extravaganza. No one's been calling it that, but I had a few too many rips of the pen today, so I'm feeling adventurous.
Yeah. It'd be cool if it were like conversational, so like stream of consciousness. If you feel like saying something, just kind of say it, and then we'll like talk to you. It's like a Q&A in the sense that we're talking to you, and like, you're talking back, so that's fucking sick. I curse a lot, I'm sorry for the child. Okay, cool.
Great to have for mature audiences. Well, surprise, we got an acoustic EP coming out later this year.
Woo, nice!
You'll hear about it very soon, and part of that, that's part of the reason we wanted to do this acoustic VIP session. And Tate and I did a few acoustic shows with 4 Years Strong back in 2019, and we were like, well, it'd be cool to do our own stripped-down tour, but seems kind of inconvenient to plan a whole tour for one thing, so tried to wrap it together, and we very much appreciate you being here, so thank you. And this one's SPS, and it is going to be on the acoustic EP.
So this one's called Wonderwall. Drinking before noon, filling up the sink with all of your empty cans. It's why you're not on the lease. I'm trying to tell you, but you're always asleep, that there's a difference between saying you're trying and doing anything. Catch the last of the summer, parts of the nights that we didn't spend wasted, grinding your teeth in your sleep till your jaw hurts, biding our time till we say you're not worth this. Catch the last of the summer, parts of the nights that we didn't spend wasted, grinding your teeth. teeth in your sleep till your jaw hurts. Biding our time till we say you're not worth this.
Woo! Yeah!
Thank you. Well, we figured we would go along and do a song and then answer some questions and do a song so that way we can knock out both in case there's time crunch or run out of time. So if we have any questions, now's a good time.
I have a question.
Yes.
So we all know that quarantine and COVID suck, and it especially took a toll on artists like yourself. How do you think that it changed the way that you connect to your fan base?
I don't feel like for me it changed that much because I felt a lot of it was online anyways. I feel like we have a really dedicated online fan base, kind of shitpost culture and fun. But you know, we miss the in real life aspect of it, but I knew that would be there when we come back, so I guess I don't feel like it changed, it just like missed something for a while.
I do appreciate after like being away for a little bit. It feels a little more exciting to come out and meet people knowing that it's not always gonna be possible. So.
Chris, this one's for you. I saw your TikTok a few days ago. Have you listened to The Good Charlottes yet?
I've been meaning to check out The Good Charlottes. Who's not filled in on the TikTok? Okay, story time. So, well, Tades, you heard about it. Tell us how you heard the other
Here's
day.
How I heard about it. My fiance comes over to me as I'm playing games on the computer and hanging out with my pets and doing whatever. And she goes, "Hey, Tades, why is Chris gaslighting kids on TikTok?" And she shows me this video of Chris like pretending he doesn't know any like pop emo song from the 2000s. I'm like, sick, that's gonna go over great.
So I was not gaslighting kids per se.
You're like, gaslighting anyone.
I was gaslighting pretty much anyone my age or maybe like older or younger by a few years. Cause I saw this other girl's viral TikTok where she predicted that she would go viral by not knowing like pop hits from the 2000s because younger millennials can't like resist saying like, "Oh, I know this and you don't." So like she got a ton of comments on it, like drive up the engagement. And I was like, "Oh, that'd be funny if I did that for emo stuff and the pop punk hits." So I had a Good Charlotte song on there and I was wearing a Good Charlotte shirt. I pretended not to know them, and then a Newfound Glory song was in the set and I pretended not to know that either, despite just finishing tour with them, and it works. I got like 1 million views now. It's crazy. I have like 5,000 comments saying I'm a poser and I suck. So mission accomplished, I guess. Fuck yeah. Okay. Any more at this moment?
So that song's SPS stands for stupid piece of shit. Is that right?
Soggy piss stickers.
Okay. Yeah. So. You're in Lawrence, and we have a very common acronym as well, and I wanted to make sure you guys knew what it was, LFK. Are you familiar with that one?
No. Let's fucking kill.
But maybe it is. Guys, what is it? Tell them.
Lawrence fucking Kansas.
Lawrence fucking Kansas.
Lawrence fucking Kansas.
Welcome to Lawrence fucking Kansas.
I prefer let's fucking kill.
I like that better.
I'm going to post that online because I don't want the FBI coming to my door. Also, yes. If anyone goes missing tonight, it wasn't me.
It was wrong.
All right, it's actually
why me?
So, all right, this one's also on the acoustic EP, and we'll get our boy Mark. Mark, come on out here. I'm just fucking with you. He's not here.
Oh.
Okay, this one's called.
No one even looked yesterday, so that was pretty good.
Drag almost everyone down.
and drives a Rocky Horror album. Loved he plans and failing class inside you. Find me in the margins of a sketchbook. Probably best to let the memory die out. I've got a ring, I think that she loved you too. But I can't get past the fact I drag almost everyone down. Painting the walls and line the hall after school. Smoking tattoos, 5 years removed, hope you'd recognize me now. I kind of miss you. Woo.
Yeah.
Nice. So nice. Round two of question time. You can ask about our boy Mark and why he's not here and all other things.
How old are you?
Seven.
Seven. Do you like this kind of music? Yeah, that's neat. What kind of music do you like? There's gotta be some other stuff.
Who's your
right?
favorite band?
Yeah.
He's here for a reason.
Okay,
okay. What's your cat's name?
Mulligan.
That's very good.
That's awesome.
Is the cat hot? That's a weird thing to say.
You're gonna like the rest of the bands on the bill, then be sure to listen to everyone because they're really cool.
Kind of.
Chris.
I know he's going through some shit right now.
Yeah, Chris spoke with him.
With who, Mark?
Mark, yeah.
Oh, yeah, we spoke.
On
was
the
on
podcast.
His radio show. Yeah. That was cool. I was really confused at the time because I was like lumped into the call with him and their producers, or his producers, and I saw the producers on FaceTime and I did see him and I heard his voice, but I thought it was someone else speaking and that I was waiting for Mark, so I was answering those questions referring to Mark in like the third person, not knowing I was talking to him, and I didn't realize like 3/4 of the way through, so I sound like a robot and like I have no idea how to talk to people.
You sound like a straight up alien.
Yeah. I sound like a complete moron, but then I assumed his camera probably wasn't on because of cancer, so that makes sense. But
that's
glad he's recovering.
The chemo's taking.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah. He said he's cancer free now, so that's
sick.
Cool. Yes. Secure the what? I'm sorry. No, not yet. Not yet.
Not yet.
Yeah, I got another row of 10. 100,000 miles.
Are you caught up now, or do you need?
I'm about caught up. Like some of these are like DIY miles, but
you want to tell everyone?
One of these is 5,000 miles. So I started counting like I don't know. It was before the Grayscale tour.
Senseless Fail?
Was it? I started counting like one tour before Senseless Fail, and now it's 100. Yeah, yeah. 100,000 miles just pretty much making circles around the United States. And now I'm doing all these, and then when I get the distance from here to the moon, which is somewhere around 205,000 miles, then I'm gonna get a little moon in place of whatever that would be. So, I'm going to be covered in these eventually, and I'm going to look like a lunatic.
You're going to look like a guy from Black Panther that has
you're
gonna
have six You're going to have six stripes.
I'm going to have six stripes.
Okay, well, if you got them, put them on. This one's not on the EP, it's just for fun. To the glass.
compliance, you'll tend to your bias. Be sure you're identical to all your peers.
Keep your head low.
Suggestive horror show.
Like clockwork.
Predictable, simple, the turn of a gear.
It's good to hate, isn't it? Popping veins, dissonance, drawing corners.
It's good to hate, isn't it? Popping veins, dissonance, drawing corners. Stranger to feel some blood on your fingers. You take away, robbery follow. Trends is a hobby, find flaws in everything else. Because you don't like yourself, woe's me. Knees dropping glass, keep your ear to the glass, woe's me.
Almost wasn't worth the bit.
Anyone here good at hacky sack before I do your question? No?
I feel like most people nowadays, like if you're good at hacky sack, that's like, oh, I also didn't have friends in high school. I get it.
Whatever, what's your question? Like what the song means, or okay, Pluto wasn't even a planet either. Even what's the first lyric to that one?
What's the first lyric to that one?
It's like something about being blue.
Holy cow, it's okay. We can't remember either. We wrote it.
It was something religious.
Newborn slips.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
Something.
Yeah.
Who's a newborn slip?
This is embarrassing.
I have a
shit.
I don't know, because
really
I lose everything.
That's how it ends. I don't remember.
It starts with like.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, help me call you back, because I'm afraid of the rain. Yeah. Yeah. Anxiety and stuff. I was risen Christian, and I don't. Like God. I grew out of Christianity pretty hard. So every now and then I'll make some songs that are very like simply, I'm not like an amazing writer, but simply coded to say like, God fucked me. And it's one of those. That one in like Scream Mountain is another one. Yeah, so.
I think it was Scream Mountain.
It was probably Scream Mountain.
Yeah.
Actually, that one makes more sense, I think.
Yeah, Scream Mountain is all that.
Yeah.
Pluto has some more, like, parental stuff, but... Yeah. I don't like him, and I don't think he likes me either. Hello.
Hi. Okay, so two-parter. First, why are you not in St. Louis, Missouri? I feel like that's a pretty known area.
You know, that's a good question.
Because LFK, that's
I'm
why.
I'm really not sure why we didn't come on this one.
That's okay. And then the other one, you can't figure it out. Who is the main shitposter on your Twitter? Because you are.
So,
like, you couldn't figure it, because he's always on Instagram Live.
Yeah, sorry. I'll do anything for the clicks.
Also, two-parter, ever coming back to Nebraska?
When did we play Nebraska? Omaha.
Yeah.
We played there at Omaha. I'm sure we'll come back.
Oh, yeah,
I don't know when.
It's a lot longer drive up to Lawrence than it is to Omaha.
Yeah.
But, second part is, I know there's just fun stories to song titles. Do you have any like really just interesting ones that you haven't really told anywhere?
I feel like I didn't really elaborate on SPS.
So you know when you're in a venue and you go, I guess, yeah, this works for everyone. So you go to a venue and you lift up the toilet seat and you look down in the toilet and it's just the inside is plastered with stickers of local bands for no reason.
Yep.
And they're covered in piss. And
soggy piss stickers. That's the way, that's the way it goes.
I hate the gooey disc is about the egg that comes on the McGriddle at McDonald's.
Oh my god. Actually, the McGriddle now is a folded omelet style egg.
Oh, really?
They which is pretty
it?
Nice. They did.
That's crazy.
It was the McMuffin at the time.
Oh, the McMuffin at the time. Yeah.
It wasn't.
Those are gross.
McGriddle doesn't have the gooey disc.
Semi-fight is semi-fight because I saw a semi-fight. Two of them, like, fucking made contact on the highway and then pulled off to either side. It was sick.
It's not scary.
Yeah, it was fine. I was far away. It's like a ways back, and I just like fucking veered off to the side.
We're just living in it, baby.
Yeah, dude, it was badass. The simulation got nuts. I'm one of those guys.
Okay, well, we'll play. We got two more. This one is Deluxe Capacitor Acoustic. It's not the electric version acoustic, it's the acoustic version.
Yeah.
clap too.
Sometimes you gotta clap for yourself.
Yes.
Could you guys talk a little bit about goals that you have, like, as a band? I'm one of the old men Hot Mulligan fans, 37 years old. I saw Fall Out Boy back in the day in a club this size, mm-hmm. and then the next time they came around, they were playing arena shows. And I feel like you guys deserve to be in an arena tour with, like, Blink and doing that kind of shit. But, like, Catch 22, I don't want that almost, because, like, I want that success for you guys. But, like, being able to come to stuff like this, like, I don't have Kanye West money, so I'm not going to be able to, you know, like, do an acoustic set when you guys get that big. But just kind of curious about what goals you guys have as a band.
Personally, I feel like being out here right now and doing this is, in a way, like, we're achieving a goal that we had set.
Yeah.
It's been a long time since we've played any headlining shows, and it's been a never time since we've ever done acoustic, you know, VIP sets. And yeah. So, in a way, I mean, we're already approaching goals like that and very thankful to be doing it. But I'm sure, I mean, there's, it goes up the ladder. The goals never stop, really.
Yeah. This tour is kind of like a 3-in-1 goal knockout for me. Like, I like doing the VIP thing and doing the acoustic stuff and having people show up for that, so that's great. And then we have a light show on this tour that I'm very excited about. And we get to tour in the wagon thing with the bunks and stuff, which is pretty cool, because normally I'm just
big goal.
sleeping, and it sucks. But no, I think, like, my next goals are, I would like to go overseas, go to Europe really bad, or Asia. I like to play bigger festivals, play more festivals.
Festivals are definitely.
Do you have any, Brandon?
You guys covered them.
I don't know. I try not to have goals. I'm just kind of stoked to be doing whatever. I don't really want for anything. I just kind of want to play video games and hang out with pets.
Oh man, my goal actually is to just have such an insane video game collection.
But, like, for real though, like, I don't know. I don't want to want for things, because this is already sick, so I don't really give a shit what happens, so long as I get to keep doing this.
We had one goal together, like, in the very beginning, or at least I had one, which was I just wanted, like, one person at a show to sing, like, one of our lines that I, like, didn't know beforehand, and then everything after that, I was like, okay, well, that happened now, so everything beyond this point is already, like, more than I could ask for, so.
We're still riding the
anything that happens now, I'm just like, holy shit, no way, that's cool.
That's awesome.
Okay.
What's up?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think I'm done with it. It's stressful. I don't know.
I don't love it either.
Yeah.
What do you play?
Games? I don't know. I play a bunch of indie games. You play, like...
I play whatever. Yeah. I don't know, streaming's hard because I feel my skill level just go down the drain, like, the moment I start to talk to people, like, very single track mind. What's up?
Watching people suck at video games.
It wasn't entertaining for me, though. I got roasted.
I got roasted, too.
We get roasted, probably.
We get roasted a lot.
Well deserved. Any others at this moment? Yes.
What?
If you guys work in Hot Mulligan, what do you guys see yourself doing?
Hopefully I'm still shit posting. Like, I could be on Wendy's Twitter, you know? That could be me instead.
I was working at a Jimmy John's for 6 years before this, so I don't really want to think about if there was no Hot Mulligan.
I probably just would have been, like, an accountant or something.
Dead or lumberjack or dead lumberjack.
So I have another question. I was thinking about the concerts that you guys did during quarantine where everybody was in their cars. How was that for you guys? Was that super weird? I mean, that's
definitely
a different...
We're just happy to do anything.
Yeah, it was really... It was weird, but it was so cool.
It was less weird than I thought it was going to be. But I feel really stoked that was kind of like an unprecedented thing, so that I'll be able to, like, look back on that later to say that, like, oh, we did the drive-in show, which I think is, like, a cool thing. Because I remember when, like, the drive-in theater in my hometown, like, reopened one night when I was in high school, and I thought that was cool. So a concert of the same vibe is neat.
Yeah,
it wasn't 38 degrees outside during that night, it probably would have been way cooler, but I was really cold.
I just had a quick thing. You were talking about the Wendy's person. They actually, the main guy that graduated from our high school.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's funny. We should fight.
Yeah. Get you connected.
Yeah. That'd be great.
Battle.
Thank you, fool.
That makes sense, you know? Yeah. You grow up like kind of nowhere, and then like you have nothing to do but shit post because all your real life friends think you're weird. So.
Have you ever seen the same guy?
What
vine? Slithering snake.
No way! Oh, I gotta make phone calls after this.
You know the vine where the kid goes, "Don't come into my house, or I'll frickin' stab you," and holds up a knife. That kid went to my high school. I also had a vine star in my day.
Okay, we got time for one more song, and then you guys can get your goodies and stuff. We thought about playing this one on the tour. We really did. We really, really did. We just couldn't do it. But we talked about maybe doing it, so we decided this moment we would play this song. So it's just for you guys. And, well, I guess everyone else
who does
the VIP. Okay, here we go.
Rewrite.
I have like approximate knowledge of these lyrics, so. Wanna fuck like one up? That's fine.
It's okay.
Well, at work, I see you. You don't see me.
Come visit my place. We'll sit and talk.
my friend says, guys, I did love you, and I still do. And how am I standing to girls who's based completely around you?
Yeah. I was kind of fucking winging it for parts of that, so.
Okay, well, I think we got time for a couple more questions until Andy comes and says he's got a Grammy. Yes.
So, are you going to expand on
Yeah, I will.
He's got bangers. And he's got them all stored on a little hard drive labeled bangers.
That's not true.
He'll go out one day. I've heard him. It's true.
I have some songs. I don't have, like, I would say explicit plans for it. I'm just kind of, if I write something and I don't want it to be a Hot Mulligan, then I'll put it out just because, I don't know, why not? No pressure, who cares? Yes?
So this might be like a favorite movie, but I remember probably back to like the Fat Boot days, you guys played a show in Hutchinson, Kansas, and a game shop. Do you remember that?
Oh, yeah. That was wicked. You were there?
Unfortunately, no. I was 45 minutes away, and I was like one of those things. But now I'm
picking
myself.
I was chucking fat clouds. Like, the vape shop.
Oh, the vape shop. Clouds. Yeah. They had one of those things on the wall that are black and white to tell like distance and time, and it was specifically so that people could stand on one end and huck a cloud out and see how far they can like blow one out, and that's. I just don't really have words for that.
We'll take a picture quick and then it's eating time.
So in addition to the acoustic set, we also got this merch. We got an awesome shirt and then like a printout, kind of like on a cardstock. It's really nice. I'm gonna get that framed. And then we got these VIP passes so we could get back into the show. We could take all this stuff to the car, and Chris and Tades were nice enough to sign my pass after the show. Basically, best concert ever. If you get a chance to see Hot Mulligan, do it. If you get a chance to do VIP, absolutely do it. Number one hot new band.